everyone. Short video today. I'm not going to go through a whole paper, but I am going to pull out a few time-sensitive little tidbits in here. So the paper we're going to look at is Birch Pollen and Aspirin Psoriasis, a Study in Salicylate Hypersensitivity. It's by Walter Shelley in 1964, so not exactly cutting-edge research, but sometimes you have to go find the older papers to find like the little building blocks and stepping stones that everybody's referencing in the new stuff. What I wanted to let you know is I have been struggling big time this week and last week. It is pollen season, tree season, for birches, and I have such a hard time. I have known for over 10 years, maybe 15 years, that during birch tree season, I am super, super sick. And I have gone and tested for birch allergy and all the, all the other trees that are pollinating and, between March and May. And I have come up negative for those. So I am not allergic to birch trees, but I always have a really hard time. And now that I know that I'm salicylate sensitive or aspirin sensitive, I've always been trying to figure out what that connection is. And this paper makes that connection for us. So this study covers, it's a case study of a boy who has psoriasis. It's pustular psoriasis. And he ended up in the hospital, I think for about 1 or 2 months in April when he lived in Philadelphia. Now he actually lived in another place in the country, and those Aprils he was fine, but only in two Aprils in Philadelphia did he, in Pennsylvania, did he have an issue. And what they ended up coming to the conclusion was they first of all got an aspirin sensitivity diagnosis, and then they correlated it to natural salicylates from food, and especially during the pollen season in Pennsylvania, where they have a very high number of birch trees. So one thing that's interesting is that, I study Salicaceae, the willow family, which actually does have salicylates in it, and I've never really noticed an issue with them. There's also other plants like Spirea and Gaultheria. This paper also references those as having wintergreen oil. And so some of the questions are, do we need to be concerned about those pollen seasons as well? And this paper actually addresses the fact that birch trees are wind pollinated, and so they have to make a very large amount of pollen so that the wind can take their pollen and take it to another tree so they can reproduce, where willows and other high salicylate plants tend to be insect pollinated. Very interesting. I've always struggled with birch tree season. So some things that I'm doing right now to manage my salicylate load and keep my levels low and my reactions low. One is I try and go out when it's like, if I go for a walk or a run, try and go out early when it's still cold. Like right now, like yesterday it was 34 degrees in the morning. So, it's a little bit better time. It's not 55 or 60 degrees when the trees are really open and releasing their pollen. So I try and be active as early as possible. I also use antihistamines, either eye drops or maybe, I don't do very well with daytime antihistamines, but this will be the time when I do use them and for short periods of time. So I can handle, maybe every other day with those for myself. Claritin and Zyrtec work better if you can take it every single day. So if you can do that, talk to your doctor, that might be a good option. Maybe use an air purifier in my office or keep my central air going to kind of take out some of those the pollen particles out of my environment. So they're just some things that I try and do. Oh, I also, because it's salicylate darn food, I obviously have a fragrance-free home. And then I also make sure that I eat very, very low on the negligible list. Well, while during the rest of the year, I might be able to eat off like the moderate list, small amounts of, maybe like a jam or something like that. During this time, I will eat basically all animal products mostly, and like iceberg lettuce. That's about as exciting as I get. So in this paper, he mentions that the leaves, flowers, fruit, stem, bulbs, bark, and roots can be found in aspens, poplars, and willows. All of those are in the Salicaceae family, the willow family. Birches and acacia, spirea, tea berry, calycanthus, camellia. Camellia is the tea family. Hyacinth, marigold, milkwort, tulips, and violet. And the violets, he specifically referenced that the flowers of viola, violet flowers, have salicylates. So don't top your cakes with those. All right, there's a lot of other plants listed on here. Nothing that I saw like really jumped out at me. So I will link this. If you want a copy of it, email me at info@lowsal-life.com. And have a great and safe spring season. Bye.